tell us what to do. Yeah. You think you could tell us what to wear? Think you better? Yeah. Well, you better get ready to bow to the master.
And here he comes, the European champion, X-Pac, set to take on Kane. But King, this is a non-title match. Mr. McMahon ordered this be a non-title match. I gotta wonder what that's all about. You figure he'd want Kane to bring home his gold. I'm telling you, Mr. McMahon works in mysterious ways. You can't always understand what he's thinking because he's so smart. I'll tell you, X-Pac and Shane, the son of the owner of the WWF, and that's a problem. 2 weeks ago, the rivalry continued. X-Pac had offered Kane a place to D-Generation X. Kane responded with a big no way.
Okay. He followed Shane McMahon's orders, and then, Shane McMahon got to ride the fucking Bronco.
But last week, X-Pac got revenge, slamming the steel cage door into the head of Kane and helping Triple H win. That happened last week in the war zone. X-Pac, the cage door into Kane, helped Triple H pick up a huge victory.
Uh-oh. Because of that man right there, X-Pac. And you can see by the way Kane is walking to the ring, he's got one thing on his mind. We talked about revenge, and that's what Kane is wanting.
This Sunday on pay-per-view, St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
Cover your ears!
Oh! This Sunday, Kane will team with China to take on X-Pac and Triple H if X-Pac gets out of this one. But this 210-pounder doesn't know the two words, I quit. And here we go now, X-Pac and Kane. The martial arts expert off the ropes, ducks underneath Kane. Obviously the quickness in X-Pac's favor, but the strength in Kane's favor.
X-Pac was out here screaming, he's not afraid, I'm not afraid. He's too stupid to be afraid. He's got more guts than brains, that's his problem.
Normally that woman there, China, would have been at ringside helping X-Pac out. Tonight she's in Kane's corner.
Yeah, you hear X-Pac, don't sing it, bring it. Don't sing it, bring it. Who cares? He's bringing it right now, ain't he, X-Pac?
China's saying, King, she joined the corporation for two reasons. She wanted some of the spotlight. She wanted some money. Bottom line. This Sunday, King, China against X-Pac, Triple H. That should be interesting.
Oh, you're not kidding. Just take a look at China standing there. I'm telling you, all that's on her mind right now, she's just watching X-Pac and she's just licking her lips. She can't wait till this Sunday on pay-per-view. Oh! She gets to get her a little bit of him.
What a clothesline by Kane. I'll tell you what, still to come tonight, King, how in the world is Stone Cold going to survive the corporate gauntlet?
He's not! Come on! Face it! I know you want to be like the rest of these Canadian morons and believe in Stone Cold, that he's invincible, that he can somehow rise to every occasion. But tonight, he is not going to be able to overcome the gauntlet. Look out!
The 330-pounder tossing X-Pac out of the ring, and the European champion in some trouble. This guy is a monster.
Man.
Dropping X-Pac on the barricade outside the ring.
You think the Toronto Argonauts could use Kane? He could be their whole offensive line.
The Toronto Raptors could use him at center. And Kane now.
Uh-oh. This is it for X-Pac.
This is ridiculous. Steel stairs. And X-Pac moves out of the way. And X-Pac back in the ring. Referee continues the count on Kane. And there now the quickness of X-Pac. Kick to the midsection again. And what a kick by X-Pac. Face first into the barricade.
I'm going to tell you this, though. If X-Pac is really smart, he's going to have to start going downstairs. That's his only hope. Got to take the legs out from under Kane. You're not going to do any good working up top there, X-Pac. Look at this.
There's the quickness of X-Pac. Kick again to the midsection.
Goes
to the legs. Drop kick to the kneecap. And there you go, King. Working low, and Kane's in trouble.
You think he hurt me?
Wait a minute. China from behind. Oh, and this Sunday, those two who are standing, China and Kane, will meet X-Pac and Triple H.
Look at this, look at this.
The ninth wonder of the world with a slam of X-Pac.
He slammed him like a feather.
Come on now.
Look at those boots China's wearing. Wait a minute, wait, what's she doing?
China calling Kane off.
I think she wants to take care of this light work herself. Oh, no! Oh, no!
This is the pedigree, King.
Out of Triple H.
And here's Triple H.
Look out!
Triple H. And here now Triple H goes to work on Kane.
Get up, China!
Double team by DX.
Get up!
And there goes Kane. Wait a minute. China wants both of them.
What?
China wants Triple H and X-Pac. Missed with a clothesline, and Kane, luckily for China, gets her out of there. Here's Shane. This Sunday, China will have her chance. China, Kane, Triple H, X-Pac at St. Valentine's Day.
It's a good thing Shane intervened. Gonna have to make her wait till Sunday.